Hello friends, welcome to the Power BI tutorial series. In this tutorial series, we will see what is the Gantt chart in Power BI. In the previous tutorial, we have seen tree map in the Power BI. So agenda of this tutorial, like how we create the Gantt chart in the Power BI. So let's go to the Power BI desktop application. So in this Power BI desktop application, in this sheet, we are going to create the Gantt chart. So for that, let's take this Gantt chart and here like will populate the data. So let's take in the values and in the the value first we will take the profit. So let's take the profit. So when we populate the data like this profit into the value, we can see like how much the profit. The profit is like 33.79 and how much it is reaching, like the profit is reaching to 16.89, and here like we can see how much the profit is there, like it is showing like this 16.89. so that is the thing. But majorly like why we use this Gantt chart, we use this Gantt chart for showing the target of the profit, like any company which is set particular target, like for this target this the profit should be either to this target or greater than this target. So for that kind of the like scenario we use the Gantt chart. But in this our sheet we don't have any target profit kind of field. So what we can do, like we can create our like one field called target profit. So what I will do, in this home page you can see this new measure. So once I'll click on this new measure, it here it will open at the top of this. We can see it is going to open one field. So here we are going to create one field for this financial data as a target profit. So basically here what we can do, when we clicked on this, like when you go on the home page and you click, when we click this new measure, so when we click on this new measure, what it do, basically whatever the column we are going to take, it will add that column into the sheet. So now what I will do, I will take instead of this measure, let's click again, and what I'm going to take, I'm going to take one column and that I will name like target profit, because we want to see like what is the target for this like for this record, like total profit is 33.79 and it is achieving 16.89, but what is the target to achieve? So that we are going to calculate. So what we will do, let's take sum, and when I click it is, see we can see here like it is showing all the column field of this financial sheet. So we have to select, like, but we are going to select for the profit because we are going to calculate for the profit, and into I'm going to take 1.5. So basically when I hit enter, so it will add one column to this field, and we can see like this is the field. Here we have like this target profit we have taken, and here it is showing symbol as a calculator. And basically what logic we have written, this logic, like target profit equal to sum, and the financial profit, like this one we are going to take, and we have multiplied with 1.5, so this will be the target profit. Now what I will do, I will take this target profit into the target value. Here we can see the target value. So when I click on this target value, like target profit in the target value, we can see it is showing like what is the target profit. So this is the target profit, and we can see like it is not achieving to that target profit. So for that kind of scenario we use this Gantt chart. Now what I will do, let's take one pie chart here. So we already have seen the pie chart, like how we create, and now I want to create this pie chart. Let's take it here, and I want to create the pie chart with, I will take like month name, and I will take the values as a profit. So here we can see like month wise how much it is showing the profit. So let's see here. Okay, instead of this month name, what I will do, I will take the product name. So let's take the product name. So it will not be much big. Yeah, we can see like with the product name it is showing. Now when I will click on any product area, we will see it will change the target profit and all over the profit. So when I click on, suppose I'm going to click for the VTT. So when I click on this, we can see like what is the total profit and what is the like target profit. And when I click for this value, and we can see like it is changing. So when I click on any particular like product, based on that, this chart, this GAC chart is also reflecting, and based on that, it is showing the total profit and the target profit. So for this kind of scenario, basically we use the GAC chart. And if we want to see based on the like product, then in that kind of scenario, we use the pie chart as well as the GAC chart. So that's all for this tutorial. If you have any question and doubt, please comment. Thank you.